Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm Lignus Monster. Today we do have some Black Series and Vintage Collection news to go over. But real quick, if you aren't subscribed, go down, hit that like button, and subscribe if you're new to the channel. It does really help me out a lot, and we are actually doing a giveaway at 5,000 subscribers. We're giving away an extra Arc Trooper Echo right there. I do have an extra one chilling at home, but I'm on vacation right now, so I can't show it. But it is actually sealed and ready to ship once we hit 5,000 subscribers, so make sure you are subbed to the channel because you do have to be subbed to enter, and onto the video. First up in the news, we do actually have a close look at the new Vintage Collection Wave with Echo, Ahsoka, Maul, and the Jawa, so I will throw up some photos right now. They all look amazing. The Echo is actually the exact same figure from the ARC Trooper 3-pack, same kind of like the 5s from before, so yeah, that's really cool. We've got two of those three figures now, which is amazing, and I cannot wait to get a Jesse as well, and we don't have any confirmation of a Jesse yet, but if we do get a Jesse, I really hope they decide to do the Phase 2 helmet with no rangefinder, kind of like he was in the actual show, rather than the Jesse figure, which was completely inaccurate. So hopefully they do that, but yeah, who knows. I really hope they do that, though. It'll make it more accurate. And also, I guess this gives the people who bought the ARC Trooper 3-pack a little bit of a like bonus rare figure with the ARC Trooper helmet rather than the accurate helmet. Then of course we do have the close-ups of Ahsoka and Maul's face, and Ahsoka looks a little off. I mean, of course it is Vintage Collection, it's harder to get those details in the face as the Black Series, but honestly it still looks pretty good, and definitely some banger figures right there. I really do like the Maul as well. I cannot wait to get a Maul in the Black Series in the Siege of Mandalore arc outfit, I guess you could call it, but that'd be really cool, and it would be, you know, it just complete the kind of Siege of Mandalore stuff we've already gotten, because we do of course have the 332nd, we have Ahsoka, and then a Maul would be amazing to go with that, but who knows. And unfortunately, next up in the news, we do have some exclusives to talk about. So first up is a Vintage Collection figure that will be exclusive to Target. Not much is known about this except for the code name, which I did not write down, but it will be on your screen. And yeah, so not a whole lot known about this. Normal Vintage Collection prices, and yeah, it's exclusive to Target, which does suck. I know Target exclusives aren't the best when it comes to stocking their figures, but with the recent Clone Wars wave, it's been on and off, because, you know, some stores will get a ton of stock and restock them a ton, and some of stores won't. So, you know, it's on and off with Target, and hopefully some of these Target figures will get stocked pretty well. And speaking of Target exclusives, we have two Black Series figures that will be exclusive to Target as well. First up is Black Series Squat is the code name, and it will retail for $26.49, which is the new like Target exclusive price range. I know halfway through the new like Target figures right there, those figures jumped up in price from $23 to $26. Like halfway through, they changed it on the website, they changed it in stores. Yeah, it's really weird that they would do that halfway through these being on shelves, but that looks like that'll be the new like Target exclusive price range, I guess. There's also another deluxe figure that will be a Target exclusive. It is codenamed Jog, and will retail for $36.99 for an exclusive figure. Yeah, that's definitely up. I believe the normal like deluxe figures price is between $30 and $35, but has been around $30. I believe the deluxe Boba Fett there was $30, and the Wrecker was $30. So $36.99 is very expensive for a deluxe figure, but I guess it is what it is. I mean, prices are going up, and I think we're just going to have to get used to it, which does really suck, but I think that's just the new normal. And we don't have any confirmation what these figures are yet. Knowing Hasbro, they're going to put more Clone Wars figures as exclusives, but I don't know. I really hope they don't, but knowing Hasbro, they probably will, because the last, what, we've gotten two full waves of Clone Wars figures that have been all exclusive to Walmart and Target. So who knows? I hope they're not, but it probably. We also have some really, really good news talking about the Lucasfilm 50th anniversary line. Wow. In 2022, it won't be the 50th anniversary of Lucasfilm anymore, but that line will actually be continuing into 2022. It just won't be titled 50th anniversary anymore. It'll just be titled the Lucasfilm something line. I don't know. It just won't be 50th anniversary anymore, which is all right, because that line is amazing. It gave us the Clone Wars figures. It gave us the like Phantom Menace Best Buy figures. They gave us the comic book figures. All those are great figures, and that line is going to be continuing, which is good, because I feel like that gives Hasbro an excuse to do random obscure figures, kind of like the Clone Wars retro wave there. And I like what that line is doing, so I'm cannot wait to see that continue into 2022. And kind of speaking of that comic book wave, if you guys actually did pre-order the Conard Jax from Hasbro Pulse, that actually got delayed until August 26th, which is very unfortunate and very confusing to me, because I find this guy in GameStops all the time. I've literally probably seen, in the last three GameStops I've went into, all those GameStops have had at least three of them. So yeah, that's surprising to me that Hasbro is delaying this. I feel like that's been a thing with Hasbro Pulse recently, where their figures ship out last, which is kind of unfortunate. So I might be personally pre-ordering my figures other than Hasbro Pulse, because I know I ordered Tech and Wrecker from Hasbro Pulse, and those are both showing up in stores now, and Hasbro Pulse still hasn't shipped them out. So yeah, that might be a tough choice in the future, but hopefully Hasbro Pulse kicks up their shipping and actually ships, you know, relatively sooner compared to some of the other stores that are shipping them out as well. And then Dorksite is actually doing a sale on their website. Throw up a photo of a bunch of figures that are on sale, but if you guys missed out on any of these, not sure the exact prices, but all these figures are on sale on their website, so go check it out. I don't know what's in stock still or what's already sold out, but go check out for yourself, and yeah, there are some really cool figures that I might have to pick up. And there's also some different stuff showing up in GameStop stores. The Black Series Flame Trooper that we actually looked at last week, that's actually starting to show up in GameStop stores in the U.S., which is pretty cool. Really cool figure. I do want to get that one if I find it in stores. But there's also the First Order Deluxe Helmet, or whatever you want to call it. The First Order Stormtrooper Helmet, pretty much, from the Black Series, is showing up in GameStops as well, which is pretty cool. It's just a repaint of the Captain Cardinal helmet white, which is actually amazing. I love the look of the First Order helmet. I know people don't like the sequels, but I really like that helmet. And if that ever goes on sale, because I know GameStop does a lot of sales, I might have to pick one up. Then last up, somebody actually found a Archive Thrawn in a Walmart for $10. So go check your Walmarts. You might have some in like clearance sections and other stuff like that. I don't guarantee you'll find a Thrawn, but there might be some of those like Grief Karga's and Archives Han and Luke from the Hoth, like Hoth, Han, and Luke. Because all those pegworm really well, and you might see some of those in clearance. But when he actually scanned it and, you know, rang it up, it actually rang up for $5, which is pretty cool. So $5 for a Thrawn is a steal. And, yeah, Walmart, like I said, Target's prices are going up. Walmart's prices are just going down. So, yeah, it's very interesting. But that is actually going to do it for the news. If you would enjoy, hit the like button and subscribe if you're new to the channel. And I'll see you guys in the next video.